Sennacherib attributed his success to his own power and his own military prowess. God reveals the thoughts of Sennacherib's heart. He says, you think by the multitude of your chariots that you're going around and conquering all these nations. You think that you can go where you want and do what you want and no one can stop you. That's how the king of Assyria thought. Matthew Henry said it this way, see how the Assyrian in his pride magnified himself as his own master and pretended to be absolute and above all control, to act purely according to his own will and for his own honor. So here's this Assyrian king. I go where I want, I conquer whoever I want, and there is not a god in existence who can stop me. God says in this prophecy to the king of Assyria, I know your dwelling place, I know where you live, I know where you go out and where you come in. And then God says, I know your rage against me. I know how much you hate me, Sennacherib. I hear your words, and I see your animosity toward my people. Everything Sennacherib did was a man with a heart full of rage. Everything he did was done out of rage, hate for God and hate for people. That's the kind of tyrant that he was. And now I want you to see how God talks about his role in Sennacherib's life. Follow me here. Look how God talks about his involvement in this whole thing. Sennacherib's drive to conquer was given to him by God. What drove this man on? Why is he so set on conquering nations? Why is he so passionate in his conquests? I submit to you, God gave him that drive. Look at verse 25. This is the Lord speaking, the second half of the verse. Now I have brought it to pass that you should be for crushing fortified cities into heaps of ruins. Why is Sennacherib destroying cities? God says, I have brought this to pass. Sennacherib's success in destroying his enemies was also a work of God. Look at verse 26. He says, therefore, their inhabitants had little power. They were dismayed and confounded. They were as the grass of the field and the green herb. What God is saying here is, all these people that you've conquered, all these nations that you've destroyed, I took away their ability to withstand you. I made them weak. I made them confused. They were easy prey for you, Sennacherib. That's really interesting, isn't it? It kind of takes away the boast. He's boasting in all these nations that he's conquered, and God says, yes, you've conquered these nations, but I made them like chaff. I made it easy for you to do this. Here's what I want you to notice. I want you to notice the ownership that God takes in this. I have brought it to pass. Just think about that for a moment. These words indicate that God was at work in the military conquests of Sennacherib. God was the one at work, even as Sennacherib was going around and destroying people. God gave this one man a powerful position of influence over a world superpower. God gave this to Sennacherib. And God also took away the strength and courage of his enemies. So you can see God is active in this whole situation. And so now we've arrived at the point that I wanted to get to with you for tonight. Here's the pinch point, so to speak. Sennacherib was going around and slaughtering people. He was crushing fortified cities. Sennacherib and the Assyrians were known for their barbaric treatment of their enemies. Study up on ancient Assyria. They were some bad dudes. They did dreadful things to those who stood in their way. This man was a proud and evil tyrant who gloated in his power. And yet God said that he was the one who brought it to pass. You feel the tension there? How could God say, I have brought all this to pass? I mean, that's what it says in verse 25.